the wilderness, your secret place. Mark chapter 1, verses 11 to 13. Then a voice came from heaven, "You are my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased." Immediately the Spirit drove him into the wilderness. And he was there in the wilderness 40 days, tempted by Satan, and was with all the wild beasts, and the angels ministered to him. This week, we continue considering the significance of the wilderness in the life of Jesus. Why did the Holy Spirit lead him first into the wilderness before he launched his ministry? Even though he had already received the Father's approval and the Father's voice that said, "You're my beloved Son, I am well pleased in you," the Spirit of God still took him out into the wilderness, and Jesus yielded to that. We see that the wilderness is God's secret place. It's God's hiding place. It's a time when he hides you before he can make you visible, before he can bring you out into visibility. And here Jesus was in a place of hiding, or in a place hidden by God, kept there, and he was alone with the Father. And then at the right time, he was released to come forth into visibility. And so this is something that you and I must learn and learn to yield to, that when the Holy Spirit moves us into our wilderness space, that is our secret place, he's saying, go into your place where nobody sees you except God. And we must learn to adapt to that. Because as people, we want to be seen. We want to be heard. We want the affirmation of others around us. And there's nothing wrong with all of that. But when we want to move into a new season, when we want to be ready to be launched into something that God wants to release through us, we need to come to this place of hiding in God and in the presence of God. Jesus put it like this in Matthew chapter 6 and verse 6. He says, "When you pray, go into your room, and when you shut your door, pray to your Father who is in the secret place. And your Father who sees in secret will reward you openly." There's something about us being in the secret with the Father, which then positions us to receive his reward, so to speak, or his works released through us when we go out into the public. Or what happens in the public should really be a result of something that has taken place in the secret with the Father. And that's what the wilderness is talking to us about. That when we yield ourselves to being in the secret place with the Father, he will reward us when we come out in the public. You know, look at John the Baptist. The Bible says in Luke 1 verse 80 that the child grew and became strong in spirit and was in the desert till the day of his manifestation to Israel. God kept him in hiding until it was the time for his revelation, for him to become visible. There's a time of obscurity before a time of visibility. The wilderness is that secret time of obscurity. You're unknown to man, but you're being made known to the Father. And then he releases you out into the public, and he releases his works through you at the right time. So yield yourself to the leading of the Holy Spirit to be in your secret place before the Father. Let's pray. Dear Lord, we ask you for the grace that we will yield, even as Jesus did, to come into that secret place, in that place, that wilderness space, to be with you in secret, so that you will reward us and we move in to the public. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.